Now, we have what I have titled three entrances.
Ce que j'ai appelé les trois entrées.
Three entrances.
Les trois entrées.
Then we have three, okay. Courts.
Ensuite, nous avons trois cours.
Then three three what?
Fists.
Three fists.
Ensuite, trois fêtes.
And then three heavens.
Enfin, trois cieux. Trois cieux.
Amen. Amen. The idea is this.
L'idée est la suivante.
One gives us through the other one to the destination. Okay. Amen.
Amen.
Chaque étape conduit à la suivante jusqu'à la destination.
He gives us his entrance.
Il a donné les entrées.
Into the courts.
Les entrées dans les cours.
While we are in the courts.
Quand on est dans les cours.
Our operations and ministry in the courts helps us to enter into the heavens.
Lorsque nous sommes dans les cours, nos opérations, nos ministères dans les cours nous aident à entrer dans les cieux.
The heavens are our destination. Amen.
Amen.
That's where we are going.
C'est notre destination, c'est là où nous allons.
God is taking mankind from dust.
Dieu prend l'homme de la poussière,
lifting him into the estates of himself in the third heavens.
Le lève à son état dans les cieux.
The terms should not be high sounding. Amen.
Amen.
They are normal words that we just need to understand. That's all. Okay.
Les termes sont des mots normaux que nous devons comprendre.
So let's start with the three entrances.
Commençons avec les trois entrées.
If that's the only one we are able to cover, we will just make mention of things in the rest, and we would have achieved our purpose. You have the gates.
Nous avons les entrées. L'entrée.
Amen. Amen. This was called the gates.
Les portes.
When you enter, you come into the outer court.
Quand on entre. On entre dans la cour extérieure.
The gates leads to the outer court.
La porte conduit à la cour extérieure.
And then in the sanctuary, this little tent was called the sanctuary.
Cette petite tente s'appelle le sanctuaire.
Or the place of meeting.
Ou la place d'rencontre.
Amen.
Amen.
Now there's an entrance here.
Également, il y a une porte ici, une entrée.
Containing five pillars.
Qui contient cinq piliers.
This was called the door.
C'est appelé la porte.
Amen.
Amen.
And then there is another entrance here.
Ensuite, il y a une autre entrée.
Hoisted upon four pillars.
Avec quatre piliers.
This was called the veil.
C'est appelé le voile.
So, three entrances.
Donc, trois entrées.
That leads us into the three courts. Where God meets with his people.
Qui nous envoie dans les trois cours où Dieu rencontre son peuple.
Amen.
Amen.
And there is the experience within each of the courts.
Il y a une expérience à l'intérieur de chaque cour.
That is the feasts.
Qui sont les fêtes.
By means of the feasts, the people of God experiences the courts of God.
Par le moyen des fêtes, le peuple de Dieu expérimente.
Amen.
Experimente de la chose.
No, not experiment.
Yes.
Experience.
Yes. Yes. Continue.
They have experience with God.
Ils ont une expérience avec Dieu.
Amen. Amen. The reason God ordained, I will explain each of these terms. So we can see the three entrances.
De façon qu'on voit les trois entrées.
The first entrance is called the gates.
La première entrée appelée la porte.
Second entrance is called the door.
La deuxième entrée Ok.
Yes, there's a difference between gates and doors.
Ok. Donc la première entrée, on pourrait l'appeler comme le portail, disons ça comme ça. Puis la deuxième entrée, la porte.
And the third entrance.
Et la troisième entrée.
Is called the veil.
Est appelée le voile.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Is it clear so far?
Est-ce que c'est clair jusqu'à présent?
We will read the scriptures. I just want us to get this. Plan. Whenever we have an experience with God,
lorsque nous avons une expérience avec le Seigneur,
it is always a journey.
C'est comme un voyage.
From the east,
de l'est,
to the west,
vers l'ouest.
Praise the name of the Lord. We are traveling in our experiences with God from this point. Westward.
Dans notre expérience avec le Seigneur, on est en train de voyager de ce point de l'est vers l'ouest.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In other words, for example,
par exemple,
when we get born again,
quand on est né de nouveau,
it's the beginning of a journey.
C'est le début d'un voyage.
From the east,
de l'est,
to the west,
vers l'ouest.
Now, let us look at what is obtained in these courts.
Voyons qu'est-ce qu'on obtient dans chacune de ces pays.
Amen. Now, the courts were just spaces.
Les
or rooms
sont juste des espaces, des salles.
The first court, called the outer court, like you know, was open to the atmosphere.
La première cour qu'on appelle le parvis, comme vous le savez, est exposée à l'extérieur.
It's just a space that is held in by this fence.
Donc, c'est un espace qui est clôturé par ces murs.
A very beautiful fence, white in color.
Un très beau mur.
From bleached linen cloth.
Fait de lin.
And it's surrounded and held in the tent or the sanctuary.
Et il entoure le sanctuaire.
The space it encloses is called the outer court.
Et l'espace que ça définit est appelé le parvis.
It is the beginning place of our encounters with God.
C'est le début de notre rencontre avec le Seigneur.
Hallelujah.
Alléluia.
We have our born again experience. It is here in the outer court.
Nous avons notre expérience de la nouvelle naissance. Ça se passe ici dans le parvis.
And there is a whole lot that goes on here.
Et il y a beaucoup de personnes qui arrivent ici.
We had the furnitures here. You had a big, gigantic altar called the brazen altar.
On a can you...
brazen altar, altar of brass.
Ok, l'autel de la cuve de rien.
Amen. Amen. And then at the right at the entrance, called the door, by the door, you had a washhand basin. The basin.
On a un bassin pour les bains.
It just contains water. It's a pool of water.
Contient juste de l'eau.
These were the main furnitures here.
Ce sont les principaux ustensiles dans cet espace.
Of course, there were other furnitures like tables, slaughtering, and all the places you have the spoons and things, all in the outer court. But those are only implements that were used with these two main.
Bien entendu, il y a d'autres types d'ustensiles dans cet espace, mais c'est des ustensiles qui sont nécessaires pour l'utilisation de ces deux principaux.
Then inside the holy place.
Maintenant, à l'intérieur du lieu saint,
you had the. Let me remove that. This holy place. You had a table of showbread.
Vous avez, donc, dans le lieu
there was a table that contained bread of the face.
Avec, comment appelle ça, du pain, des pains propositions.
Amen. And then you had a candlestick here.
Et nous avons également
un chandelier. Yes, chandelier. Then we have one other furniture that doesn't, you know, it belongs here, but it is here most of the time. And only comes here once in a year.
Okay. Et on a un autre élément qui, en fait, appartient au lieu très saint, mais la plupart du temps se retrouve dans le lieu saint et est utilisé une fois par année dans le lieu très saint.
It was called the altar of incense.
C'est appelé l'autel de parfum.
Then of course you have one furniture here, two in one really, called the Ark of the Covenant and the Mercy Seat.
Et donc dans le lieu très saint, il y a comment? Oui, il y a l'Arche de l'Alliance qui est en fait deux morceaux en un.
Praise the Lord. Amen. All right, we are going to do well today. Hallelujah. Yes. Now, we want to be deliberate about this. Each of the courts was made by God
a été fait par le Seigneur
to enable us experience Him.
Pour nous permettre de l'expérimenter.
Amen. Amen. And God wanted to reveal Himself stage by stage.
Le Seigneur veut se révéler à nous étape par étape, niveau par niveau.
And so He did it step by step.
Donc il a fait étape par étape.
Here He deals with our sins.
Dans le parvis, il traite nos péchés.
We will explain all of this. We'll go to the scriptures very soon, but I want to give you an overview first.
Okay. On allait expliquer tout cela dans les Écritures, mais dans un premier temps, je vais vous donner une vue d'ensemble.
In the holy place,
dans le lieu saint,
He exposes us to divinity.
Il nous expose à la divinité.
Amen. Amen. He teaches us the first steps into divinity.
Il nous explique les premières étapes vers la divinité.
How to experience who God is as opposed to what man is. Okay.
Comment il nous montre comment Dieu est comparé à comment l'homme est.
It is like giving us a foretaste so that we do not, you know, fall apart when we come into the Holy of Holies. If we come into this place without the experience here, we die. Okay.
Donc ce que le Seigneur fait dans le lieu saint, il nous donne un avant-goût. Parce que si nous n'expérimentons pas cet avant-goût, les plus qu'on va directement dans le lieu très saint, on meurt.
Amen. Let me rephrase that.
Laissez-moi rephraser cela.
Because to die is a good thing.
Parce que mourir est une bonne chose.
But to be destroyed is what really I meant.
Mais pour être détruit, c'est réellement ce que je voulais dire.
If we come in here without this first taste, foretaste, will be destroyed. No man can see God and live. Amen.
Si nous allons dans le lieu très saint, savoir expérimenter cette première étape, voir un aperçu de la divinité du Seigneur, que nous allons dans le lieu très saint, nous serons détruits parce que aucun homme ne peut voir le Seigneur et vivre.
And so, in the holy place, God gives us a foretaste.
Donc, dans le lieu saint, le Seigneur nous donne un avant-goût.
He introduces you gradually to Himself.
Il s'introduit graduellement à lui.
He takes you into the spirit realm.
Il nous envoie dans la réalité spirituelle.
And for the first time, you will see the vastness and the greatness of the spirit world.
Et pour la première fois, on commence à percevoir la grandeur, l'immensité du monde spirituel.
He gives you introduction into His divine omnipotence.
Il nous donne introduction à sa divine omnipotence.
And He shows you a little bit of His nature.
Et il nous montre un tout petit peu de sa nature.
And exposes you to the culture of His place.
Et il nous expose à la culture de son royaume.
Amen. That is done here.
Ça c'est fait dans le lieu saint.
Before He brings you into this place.
Avant qu'il nous amène dans le lieu très saint.
Where you become one with Him.
Là où on devient un avec lui.
And you truly begin to live.
Et on commence réellement à vivre comme des êtres divins.
Amen.
Amen.
So that is the courts.
Ça,
then the feasts.
Ensuite les fêtes.
Are the things you do.
C'est les choses qu'on fait.
The ethics.
Ethics.
Yes.
L'éthique.
The experiences you are expected to go through. The how to.
L'expérience dans laquelle on est supposé rentrer. Le comment.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So when you come in the holy place or in the course, the feast shows you how to or what to do. These are the things you must do and the glory of God will come. We'll talk more about that.
Donc, quand on rentre dans le lieu très saint, les fêtes nous montrent les choses à faire.
Those things you must do in order to experience
les choses à faire pour expérimenter
the true intent of God in each of the courts is what we call the feasts.
L'intention réelle du Seigneur, c'est ce qu'on appelle les fêtes.
Amen.
Amen.
So God gives us the feasts to run the affairs in the courts so that we can experience it.
Donc Dieu nous donne les fêtes pour faire ce qu'il y a à faire dans le parvis et ensuite commencer à l'expérimenter le lieu saint.
Then what you become if you thoroughly experience the feasts is called the heavens.
Et donc ce que vous devenez lorsque vous expérimentez réellement les fêtes s'appelle les cieux.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And so this morning we are going to begin with the entrances.
Et ce matin, nous allons commencer avec les entrées.
Let us look at the entrances.
Regardons ensemble les entrées.
All right, turn in your Bible to Exodus chapter 27.
Exode 27.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
From verse 14.
Du verset 14.
Thank you, Lord.
Merci.
All right, we're going to just take a few readings, and then we will start off. Praise the Lord. Verse 14. The hangings of one side. Okay. All right, I'll read from verse 14. I'm actually going to verse 17, but let's read on. The hangings of one side of the gate shall be 15 cubits, and their pillars 3, and their sockets 3. And on the other side shall be hangings of 15 cubits, their pillars 3, and their sockets 3. And for the gates of the court shall be an hanging of 20 cubits of blue, of purple, and scarlet, and fine twined linen, wrought with needlework, and their pillars shall be 4, and their sockets shall be what? 4. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 17. All the pillars round about the court shall be filleted with silver. Their hooks shall be of silver, and their sockets of brass. The length of the court shall be 100 cubits, and the breadth 50 cubits. Everywhere, and the height 5 cubits of fine twined linen, and their sockets of brass. All the vessels of the tabernacle in all the service thereof, and all the pins, and all the pins of the court shall be of brass. And we say, Amen.
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 All right, Psalm 100. Turn in your Bible to Psalm 100. Psalm 100. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. It's all right. Hallelujah. Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Let's read verse 4 together. One go. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. And we say, Amen. Amen. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. Acts of Apostles, chapter 3.
Which verse?
From verse 1. Acts of Apostles, chapter 3, from verse 1.
Okay. So take
Acte 3 à partir du verset.
Yes. Just take note. Now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the house, at the hour of prayer, being the ninth hour. And a certain man lame from his mother's womb was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that enter into the temple. Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked an alms. Peter, fastening his eyes upon him with John, said, "Look on us." And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. And Peter said, "Silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, give I thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and lifted him up, and immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he leaping up stood and walked, and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. And we say, amen.
Amen.
Okay, go back to Leviticus. Exodus chapter 27 that we just read.
Retournons à Exode chapitre 27.
David said, "Enter his gates with thanksgiving."
David dit, rentrons dans ses portes avec reconnaissance.
Now, look up, or look this way. You are actually up. Now, this gate,
cette porte,
was made from bleached linen threads of four different colors.
Ce premier portail était fait de lin de différentes couleurs.
Of blue,
bleu,
purple,
violet,
red, scarlet,
rouge,
and pure white.
Et blanc, un blanc pur.
And it was neatly woven together, beautiful cloth.
Et c'était dressé ensemble, très beau.
When you look at the tabernacle in the wilderness standing,
quand on regarde le tabernacle de loin,
the background was white because this fence was made from bleached white cloth, linen.
L'arrière est complètement blanc parce que c'était fait de fin linen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Merci.
So, remember, the rest of the world are out here.
Le reste du monde est à l'extérieur ici.
The unbelieving world.
Le monde des incroyants.
And God expects them to come and have a relationship with Him in the outer court.
Et le désir de Dieu, c'est qu'il
puisse, in the Holy of Holies,
qu'il puisse venir avoir une expérience avec le Seigneur dans le lieu.
Through the outer court,
à travers le parvis.
Through the holy place,
à travers le lieu saint.
Into the Holy of Holies,
et dans le lieu très saint.
Beginning with the nation of Israel,
commençant par la nation d'Israël.
God put out this tabernacle.
Dieu a mis en place ce tabernacle.
In the midst of a desolate wilderness,
donc au milieu d'un endroit désert,
where there is no light, no water.
Un endroit où il n'y avait pas d'eau, pas de lumière.
When you see this house, this tent,
quand tu vois cette tente,
it was pure white,
c'était un blanc pur.
Of course, the white fence represents the lifestyle of the Christian, okay, the righteous lifestyle of the Christian that separates him from the world.
En fait, ce mur blanc qu'on voit, elle représente le style de vie des enfants de Dieu, de cette vie de justice, de droiture, qui peut être vue par le monde extérieur.
God intends,
l'intention du Seigneur,
that every Christian,
que chaque chrétien,
must be distinct,
soit se distingue,
from the rest of the world,
du reste du monde.
When somebody looks at you,
quand quelqu'un regarde un enfant de Dieu,
they should be able to tell without talking to you.
Ils doivent être capables, sans même parler à la personne, de dire
that you are a child of God.
Et toi, tu es un enfant de Dieu.
The white color of the cloth that surrounded the tabernacle speaks of our righteousness and purity of life.
Donc le mur blanc pur du tabernacle symbolique représente notre vie de droiture.
The house of God must have this moral purity.
that separates it from the world.
La maison doit avoir cette pureté morale qui nous sépare du monde.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We cannot afford to be like the world. A situation where you can no longer tell the difference between a Christian and an unbeliever is troublesome. Yes.
Nous ne pouvons pas accepter, supporter de vivre dans une situation où il n'y a pas de distinction entre nous et ceux du monde.
It's not the will of God.
Ce n'est pas la volonté du Seigneur.
Amen.
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 I must think different.
Je dois penser différemment.
I must look different.
Je dois parler, être différent.
I must be different.
Je dois être différent.
From the rest of the world.
Du reste du monde.
Glory to God.
Gloire à Dieu.
You know, the whole world lies in darkness.
Yes.
Le monde entier aime les ténèbres.
The whole world is dirty.
Sale.
Filthy. Sinful.
Péché.
Bad.
Mauvais.
That's what the Bible says. I'm not the one calling them so.
The Bible says
the whole world lies in darkness.
Le monde, le Seigneur dit que le monde entier vit dans les ténèbres.
But when any of us have become or claims to be God's temple, which is this,
et quand nous devenons le tabernacle du Seigneur,
there must be a white wall.
Il doit avoir un mur blanc.
That separates us.
Glory.
There should be no ambiguity.
Il ne doit pas avoir d'ambiguïté.
Amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Que notre Seigneur soit béni.
But that was not all.
Mais c'est pas tout.
What really was attractive about the house of God was the gate.
Ce qui est encore attractif, qui nous attire, c'est le portail.
The gate was fantastic.
Le portail est fantastique.
Four, five different colors.
Quatre couleurs différentes.
When you looked at that gate from afar off, it was beautiful.
Quand tu le vois de loin, c'est beau.
That was where the crippled man was sitting. He was sitting right here.
Ça, c'est là que la personne infirme était assise.
Acts chapter 3 calls it a beautiful gate.
Hallelujah.
Acts chapitre 3 l'appelle la belle porte.
The entrance into that temple was made from these five different colors. When you looked at it from the outside, it was so attractive.
Cette entrée était faite de ces quatre différentes couleurs. Quand tu regardes l'extérieur, c'est vraiment attrayant.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It speaks of the beauties of the Christ.
Ça parle de la beauté du Christ.
And all who believe in him.
Et de ceux qui croient en lui.
Amen.
Amen.
It's so beautiful.
C'est so beau. C'est tellement beau.
The heavenly lifestyle.
La vie du ciel.
Represented by the blue color.
Représenté par la couleur bleue.
The gift of eternal life that was freely given to all who believe.
Le don de la vie éternelle qui est donné à tous ceux qui croient.
And then you have the scarlet, the red, which speaks of the sacrificial life of Christ through his blood.
Ensuite, il y a la couleur rouge qui fait référence à la vie sacrificielle.
All our sins and guilt are washed away by his blood without an effort from us.
Nettoyé par le Seigneur sans aucun effort de notre part.
Glory to God.
Gloire à Dieu.
I don't have to do good or bad.
Je n'ai pas à faire bien ou mal.
All I need to do is to believe in what he did for me.
Tout ce que j'ai à faire, c'est de croire en ce qu'il a fait pour moi.
Amen.
Amen.
He bare my sins in his own body on the tree.
Il a porté mon péché sur son propre corps.
That I, being dead to sin, should live unto righteousness, with whose stripes I was healed.
Afin que mort au péché, je puisse vivre.
This gate was indeed beautiful.
Cette porte est si belle.
Forgiveness of sins.
Pardon des péchés.
No longer bearing my guilt.
Plus de culpabilité.
I'm justified and released and let go.
Justifié et relâché, libre.
To make it more beautiful, I am released from bondages, free of charge.
En plus, rend ça plus beau, je suis libéré de tout lien.
Hallelujah.
Sans aucune dette.
Glory to God.
Gloire à Dieu.
You know, our brother said something yesterday, Alain.
Notre frère Alain a dit quelque chose hier.
And he said, look.
Il dit, regarde.
When you know the word of God.
Quand tu connais la parole de Dieu.
It is so powerful.
C'est tellement puissant.
It frees you completely.
Tu rends libre complètement.
Many times you don't even need special ministration anymore.
Bien souvent, t'as même pas besoin d'un ministère particulier.
Because you just know what was done for you on the cross.
Parce que tu sais ce qui a été fait pour toi à la croix.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The day of the great day of atonement, which we will talk during this meeting, the trumpet of atonement was sounded on the trumpet of jubilee was sounded on the great day of atonement.
be a little hard for me to translate.
Jubilee. What's Jubilee?
The jubilee.
Okay. Yes. The trumpet that announced Jubilee.
Qui annonce le jubilee.
Was sounded on the great day of atonement.
Sonne on the.
The great day of atonement. The day of the feast of atonement.
Okay. Le jour de l'expiation.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, what we all know what Jubilee represented to us.
Nous savons tout ce que représente le jubilée.
On the day of Jubilee,
le jour du jubilée,
all your debts were written off.
Toutes tes dettes sont effacées.
Amen. Amen.
You return to your ancestral land.
Tu retournes à la terre de tes ancêtres.
If somebody took anything from you, it is returned back to you.
Si quelque chose a pris, quelque chose, on doit te le retourner.
No argument, no struggle. You can't say no, I'm not returning.
Il n'y a pas d'argumentation. Tu ne peux pas dire non, je ne te le rends pas.
During that feast, anybody who refuses will be destroyed by God himself.
Le jour de jubilé, celui qui refuse de se soumettre, de rendre libre. Détruit par le Seigneur.
We know the only guy who collected our things from us, isn't it?
Nous connaissons la seule personne qui prend les choses.
Who is he?
C'est qui?
Satan. He is the one keeping people in bondage.
C'est lui qui tient les gens sous.
He won't let them have children.
Il veut pas qu'on leur
donne. He will keep put sickness in their body.
La maladie dans le corps.
He will put all things from them. On the great day of atonement,
mais le jour du jubilé,
we are loosed from it.
Amen.
You are free. The children are free.
Les enfants sont libres.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Without prayers, the announcement of jubilee sets you free completely.
L'annonce du jubilé, tu es complètement libre.
Oh, this gate is really a beautiful gate.
Cette porte est si belle.
For your past sins, you will never be held accountable for them ever again in this age or in the one to come.
Tes péchés passés, tu n'es plus redevable de cela.
You are justified.
Tu es justifié.
Declare no longer guilty.
Tu es déclaré, tu n'es plus.
Our justification.
Notre justification.
Is a powerful one.
Est puissante.
There is a difference between forgiveness.
Il y a une différence entre pardonner, le pardon.
And remission.
Et la rémission.
The difference between the two is this.
La différence entre les deux est ceci.
You can be forgiven.
Tu peux pardonner.
But you will still be labeled an ex-convict.
Mais,
you know what an ex-convict is? They will say he once committed this sin. So in Nigeria, for instance, and I know in the US, you cannot vie for the office of the president, isn't it? If you are an ex-convict.
Okay. Je vais m'essayer là pour la traduction. Donc, tu es pardonné, mais déjà quand même, tu dois quelque chose. Est-ce que c'est correct?
Yeah. Remission
la is rémission,
when that thing is not only blotted out, it is not on record anymore.
Ok, la rémission, non seulement, c'est pas que c'est juste, comment on appelle ça là, tu es juste comme pardonné, mais c'est complètement effacé.
Praise the name of the Lord of God.
Hallelujah.
As far as the records of God are concerned, it never happened.
En ce qui concerne le registre du Seigneur, c'est comme ça, c'est jamais, c'était jamais produit.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even if you were a murderer,
même si on était meurtrier,
an adulterer,
un adultère,
a witch. These are the very bad ones, isn't it? Even if your sin fell in this category,
même si tes péchés tombent dans cette catégorie,
you were a hater of God. Somebody who hates God, you don't want to hear about God.
Quelqu'un qui déteste Dieu.
When you come to this gate,
quand tu viens à cette porte,
and you come to understand,
et que tu comprends,
this is why it is beautiful that. This sin, because you have said, Lord, I'm really sorry.
Juste parce que tu t'es confessé.
This will be written off.
Cela est effacé.
Your witchcraft will be written off.
La sorcellerie est effacée.
Even if you ate human beings.
Même si tu as mangé un homme.
I'm trying to make it as bad as it can be.
Essaie de le rendre plus mauvais.
If you were an adulterer, a very bad one.
Même si tu étais un adulte.
Or you were a murderer, you killed many people.
Un meurtrier qui a tué plusieurs personnes.
Even some of the latter have repented.
Tu te répands.
You understand what we are saying?
Vous comprenez ce que j'ai dit?
God simply just forgives and wipes it away.
Yeah.
And it does not exist in his records.
Et ça n'existe plus.
It never happened.
C'est comme ça n'a plus, ça n'a même pas existé.
That is the extent of our justification.
Ça c'est l'extension de notre justification.
Isn't that beautiful?
C'est pas beau ça.
To know that nothing is hanging on your conscience.
De savoir qu'il y a rien qui est encore dans ta
conscience. In the day of judgment, you will be marching. You are not afraid. What if, oh, when I get there now, they will bring up, they will open the books and bring out one thing I did that I have forgiven, I have forgotten.
Okay. Le jour du jubilé, tu n'es plus inquiet de quoi que ce soit. Est-ce qu'on va aller sortir quelque chose dans le vieux placard là-bas de quelque chose que j'ai fait?
Alléluia!
C'est complètement libre.
This is what made the Christ attractive to the sinner.
C'est ce qui rend Christ attractif pour les pécheurs.
The love of God exhibited by this beautiful gate was
l'amour du Seigneur serious. Révélé par cette belle porte.
No wonder this crippled man decided to go and stay there. He was just looking at the gate. Oh, what a beautiful gate. Oh, that I might experience this.
Cet infirme était assis à cette porte, disant, oh, quelle belle porte.
Hallelujah! Yeah. And then Peter and John came.
Et Pierre et Jean arrivent.
And they said to him, and this is something that I don't think many of us here, including me, have ever thought of. Peter and John came.
Jean et Pierre arrivent
to the place.
À cette place.
And they made a prophetic statement.
Et ils ont fait une affirmation prophétique.
That statement was loaded.
Silver
and gold have I none.
J'ai ni or ni argent.
There is no silver here in the outer court. There is no gold in the
outer court.
Where is the silver and gold?
Où est l'or et l'argent dans le lieu, dans le sanctuaire?
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
When they say silver and gold have I none, it's not that they didn't have money or any other. The early church, the Bible said they had so much, they distributed and nobody lacked anything.
Okay. Ce n'est pas qu'ils n'avaient pas d'argent sur eux, mais quand ils disaient.
It's the same church we are talking about.
Je n'ai ni or ni argent, c'était une...
Peter and John were talking something much more prophetic.
Okay.
John et Pierre disaient quelque chose de plus prophétique.
You are sat in the outer court.
Tu es assis dans le parlement.
Where there is no silver or gold.
Il n'y a pas d'or, il n'y a pas d'argent.
Such as I have, give I thee.
Ce que j'ai.
In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. He invoked the beauty of the gate.
Il a invoqué la beauté de la porte.
Free healing. Free deliverance.
La liberté, la délivrance.
Forgiveness of sins.
Pardon des péchés.
They didn't even ask him, okay, what is, maybe it was your father that sinned that made you crippled and now you are sitting here all your life. No.
Ils n'ont pas demandé est-ce que c'est à cause de ton papa qui a fait quelque chose, quoi que ce soit, non.
Silver and gold have I none.
Ni or ni argent.
Even though you are living in the place where there is no silver or gold, we have something that will deal with your problem.
Même si tu es à l'endroit où il y a ni or ni argent, il y a
quelque chose. What is the thing that deals with the problem here? Brass. All the implement here is brass.
Tout ce qu'il y a là, c'est le cuivre.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So that is the gate.
Ça, c'est là, le portail.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart.
Rentrons dans la porte avec reconnaissance.
And then I will get into the courts with praise. Amen.
Dans le parvis.
Isn't that what happened to the crippled man?
Yes. C'est parce qu'il est arrivé à l'homme qui était.
The moment they took him by the hand and lifted him up, the Bible says he's leaping up, stood, walking and leaping and praising God. Amen.
La Bible,
Psalm 100 was being fulfilled exactly.
La Bible nous dit que lorsqu'il a été guéri, qu'est-ce qu'il a fait? Il s'est levé, l'a loué, l'a adoré le Seigneur.
That is the first entrance.
Ça, c'est la première porte.
When a man passes here,
quand l'homme traverse un homme,
the first thing that he encounters is one gigantic altar made of brass, wood, sheeting wood, overlaid with brass.
Donc, ce qu'il expérimente, c'est vraiment du bois recouvert de cuivre.
When we deal with the furniture, we can do details, but I'm just because I want to get here quickly, okay. Because we want to just deal with the entrances.
Okay.
Now, this was made of brass.
Ça, c'est fait de cuivre.
Brass represents judgment.
Ça représente le jugement.
The ability of God to deal with sin.
L'habilité du Seigneur de traiter le péché.
The omnipotence of God at dealing with sickness, disease, satanic oppressions, demonic possessions and all of that. This altar is brutal when it comes to dealing with those things.
Okay.
It doesn't spare them.
Okay. Donc, à ce niveau-là, le Seigneur traite le péché, l'oppression, toutes ces genres de choses-là, puis de façon exécutive.
Let me describe the power of this altar. You kill a whole cow, a bullock.
Vous tuez une brebis.
And when you kill it,
quand vous le tuez,
remove the skin, cut it into pieces and drop them inside this altar.
Okay. Verse le sang dans cette cuve.
As long as a whole cow, put it in, it will reduce it to ashes completely. And as if that was not brutal enough, there is a grate, a sieve, to make sure no flesh is left. After sieving out the ashes, any flesh remaining will continue to deal with it until there is no flesh left.
Okay.
Such was the power and brutality of this altar when it comes to dealing with your sins on godliness. That's why the sinner can rejoice and not think, oh, maybe God will come back, he will remember tomorrow and say, no, you did this.
Okay. Dans cette portion-là, c'est vraiment brutal. Tout ce qui est de la chair, on ne peut même pas laisser, c'est vraiment très, le Seigneur, il n'y a pas de négociation.
Amen.
This is the cross.
C'est la croix.
The cross of Christ.
La croix du Seigneur Jésus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when the devil encounters the cross, he doesn't like it.
Quand l'ennemi rencontre la croix, il n'aime pas cela.
When sickness is encountered the cross, they are not spared.
Quand la maladie rencontre la croix.
All we need to understand is that we've come in at the beautiful gate. The message of God brought us to this altar, and whatever is contrary to Christ will be reduced to nothing here.
Ce que nous devons comprendre lorsque nous rentrons par cette porte, la croix du Seigneur Jésus prend de la source.
Will be reduced to nothing.
Okay, la croix du Seigneur Jésus réduit tout ce qui n'est pas de Christ.
Hallelujah. Such is the power of the cross.
C'est la puissance de la croix.
When Jesus died on the cross,
quand Christ est mort à la croix,
he took the last bit of suffering for mankind.
Il a pris le dernier bout de souffrance de l'homme, la nature humaine.
Every suffering you can think of,
he took it. Toutes les souffrances auxquelles vous pouvez penser, il a prises à la croix.
He was beaten with stripes and practically the Bible said he got about 39 stripes.
La Bible dit qu'il a reçu à peu près 39 coups de fouet.
And science will tell you that all the sicknesses that is known to mankind have been removed from these 39 sources.
Okay. Et toutes les maladies que l'homme peut avoir en leurs racines dans ces.
Whether it is infections.
Infections.
Or cancer.
Cancer.
Barrenness. You know, ulcers, yes, it doesn't matter what it is, the cross
la croix
took care of it, including death,
incluant la mort.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Le nom du Seigneur soit béni.
On the cross, he died.
À la croix, tout cela.
They buried him.
L'infidélité.
He went to the last vestige of death.
Il est allé le plus profond de la mort.
The last reservatory of the power of death.
La dernière réserve de la puissance de la mort.
And overturned it from there.
Et renversé cela.
And came out of the grave.
Et sorti de.
There's nothing left.
Rien n'est resté.
That can hold you down.
Qui peut vous maintenir.
Death has been defeated.
La mort a été vaincue.
Rebellion has been defeated.
La rébellion a été vaincue.
Sin has been defeated.
Le péché a été vaincu.
Ungodliness of every kind has been defeated.
L'impiété a été vaincu.
Sicknesses of every sort has been defeated.
Toute maladie de quelque sorte que ce soit a été vaincue.
Failure of every kind has been defeated.
L'échec de toute nature a été vaincu.
Because of the brutality of the cross.
À cause de la brutalité de la croix.
Look, when they beat Jesus,
regardez quand ils ont frappé Jésus.
Like I always say, what you see hanging in crucifixes in people's homes is not Jesus.
Ce que vous voyez accroché à la croix dans les maisons des croix dans la maison de.
No, that is not Jesus.
C'est pas Jésus.
Isaiah 52 said, by the time they were done with him, You could not recognize him. He didn't even look like a human being anymore.
La Bible dit que quand ils ont fini avec tous les châtiments, tu pouvais même plus le reconnaître.
Some people said that the passion of Christ was too gruesome, that people should not. They could not even describe it properly, as gruesome as it looked.
Certains disent que la passion du Christ était trop brutale, tout ça, mais laissez-moi vous dire que ce n'a rien à voir comparé à ce que le Seigneur.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the closer. It came closer than the film Jesus of Nazareth. That
one was too cosmetic. Du film Jésus de Nazareth qui est très cosmétique.
Praise the name of the Lamb of God.
Le Seigneur soit béni.
This altar is truly gruesome at the way it deals with anything that is ungodly.
Tout ce qui n'est pas du Seigneur, cet hôtel-là, je veux dire, le traite de façon définitive.
And that is when a person have received the gospel.
Quand quelqu'un a reçu l'évangile.
At the gates.
À la porte.
When he comes in here, this cross deals with every desire and taste for sin.
Okay. Cet hôtel-là traite tout désir, tout intérêt pour le péché.
When a person believes on the Lord Jesus Christ and is continuing to sin,
quand quelqu'un croit au Seigneur Jésus puis continue de pécher,
he should find out what he saw when he was here. Was the gate beautiful to him? If it was not beautiful to him, he is likely to come in here. When he sees the brutality of the cross, he will run away and come back out. He does not want to continue. Okay. Hallelujah.
Quelqu'un qui voit la brutalité de la croix nouveau converti, s'il pouvait voir ça, il voudrait même pas s'en approcher.
But when you have properly, you know, you saw something beautiful here. When you enter, you are the one that will be calling for the cross to come in.
Okay. Donc quand tu as vu la beauté de la croix et que tu as de la porte que tu as traversée, tu vas vouloir que d'autres viennent aussi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that brings us, we are not dealing with the courts. In the outer court, this is where the matter of sin is dealt with.
C'est là que les questions liées au péché sont traitées.
How a Christian turns out in their journey is a factor of how they handled this place, the outer court.
Comment le chrétien évolue dans ce voyage-là dépend de comment ça se passe au niveau du parvis.
Amen.
Amen.
The experience here is so total that by the time the Lord is leading people, moving people into the Holy of Holies, this place will no longer be relevant.
Okay. L'expérience ici est tellement puissante que par le temps qui se rend ici, ça c'est même plus pertinent.
Do we understand that?
Yes.
You can see why the outer court, the court which is out, it will be given over to the Gentiles.
Okay.
The Gentiles need this court.
C'est
you will not need it anymore.
Le chrétien.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Because by the time you are moving into the Holy of Holies, you have been long dead. And you don't need anything to kill you anymore.
Par le temps que tu te rends au lieu très saint, tu es mort au péché.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I will follow that.
Yes.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving. Into his courts with praise. Now we have three courts.
Nous avons trois cours.
Now, there's something I want to bring out here.
Quelque chose que je veux faire ressortir ici.
How many pillars?
Combien de piliers?
Held on this gate.
Supporte cette porte.
Exodus chapter 27. I want you to look at it.
Exodus.
Because that is very important to the kingdom message.
C'est important pour le message du royaume.
Amen.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. Verse 15, 14 and 15.
Verset 14 et 15. Exodus 27.
Now, I want us to read it together and I want you to see the pillars.
Je vais qu'on lise ensemble et que vous prêtez attention.
And we're going to look at what these pillars are and what they should mean to those of us who have fled the city and we are going on to perfection.
Que sont ces piliers?
Okay, verse 14 and 15. Let's read it together. Are we all there?
Yes.
All right, let's read. One, go. Let the French people read it first. And then the English will read it.
Okay, on va d'abord le lire en français et ensuite on va
Exodus chapter 27, verse 14 and 15.
Exode 27, verset 14 et 15.
Amen.
En français.
Okay, one, go. Amen.
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 Okay, English. Let's read it now, 14 and 15. One, go. The hangings of one side of the gate shall be 15 cubits, their pillars 3, and their sockets 3. And on the other side shall be hangings 15 cubits, their pillars 3, and their sockets 3. Now, how many pillars do we have there? How many pillars?
Six pillars.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, we want to quickly look at this so that we put them. You know, why people run away from this Old Testament stuff is that sometimes it sounds so Old Testament. So, and so they don't want to have anything to do with it. But what are pillars? Pillars are people.
Amen. Ce sont les personnes.
Amen. Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. Let's quickly read.
Apocalypse.
Yes. Revelation chapter 3, verse 20.
Apocalypse 3, verset 20.
Verse 20.
Verset
20. Are we there?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, let me, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Okay. Verse 21. I want that part that says, those who overcome, I will make them pillars in my Father's house, and they will no go no more out. Verse 12, sorry. Verse 12.
Okay.
Now, I want you to look at chapter 3, verse 12. Are we there?
Yes.
Uh-huh. So, I want you to read that. Let's read. I will read it. Now, follow me as I read it because of time.
Suivez-moi, je vais lire.
He that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God. And I will write upon him my new name. Now you find pillars here. Those who overcome are going to be made pillars. So pillars are people. Amen. Okay. Let's look at another scripture. Okay, interpret that.
Okay.
Sorry.
Donc, les piliers, ce sont des personnes. Et ceux qui vaincront, je ferai d'eux des piliers dans ma maison.
Galatians chapter 2, verse 9 also. I want you to see. I just want to establish the fact that pillars represent people.
Galates chapitre 2, ce que je veux faire ressortir que les piliers représentent des personnes.
Amen. Amen. Galatians.
Galates.
Chapter 2, verse 9.
Chapitre 2. Verse 9.
Okay. Are we there?
Yes.
Okay. And when James, Kepha, and John, that's Peter and John, who seemed to be pillars, James, Peter, and John are called pillars. So when you are talking of. Okay, sorry.
Pierre et Jean sont appelés des pillars.
Amen.
Amen.
So when you are talking of pillars, therefore, you are talking about men.
Quand on parle des piliers, on parle de personnes.
In other words, ministries, gifts of men.
Les ministères donnés aux hommes.
When men begin to live overcomers and victorious lives in the house of God, they are referred to as pillars. The ministry gifts in the house are called pillars.
Quand l'homme prend le dessus sur le péché, que le Seigneur donne comme des piliers,
le Seigneur les appelle des piliers.
Praise the name of the Lamb of God. So, let's now come back to the tabernacle.
Retournons au tabernacle.
The gate,
les portes,
was hoisted on six pillars.
La porte tenait sur six piliers.
Six is the number of man.
Six, c'est le nombre de l'homme.
In other words, men that have been chosen,
les hommes qui ont été
choisis, redeemed, and ordained by God are the ones who become gates. Gates are men who are opened up to God through whom God can bring people unto himself.
Les personnes qui ont été rachetées du Seigneur, auxquelles que le Seigneur vraiment a ordonné, investi, deviennent comme des piliers, des portes.
In that Exodus scripture, it says that these pillars are set, you know, upon what? Sockets of brass, right? Okay, let's look at it. And the gates of, let me read from verse, verse 15. And on the other side, 6 and so on. Okay, and there are sockets, 3. He said, and for the gate of the court, there shall be hanging of 20 cubits of blue or purple. And then he said, and there are sockets. He was talking of hangings. Now, all the pillars, verse 17, round about the court shall be filleted with silver. In other words, you have this.
That is, you see.
You have a pillar. It is filleted with silver,
attaché avec l'argent,
and it is set in a socket, a foundation. This word translated socket also means a foundation. It's set on a foundation of brass.
Qui était fait de cuivre.
Now, what is the meaning of this?
Que cela signifie-t-il?
All who have been redeemed.
Ceux qui ont été rachetés.
Silver speaks of redemption.
L'argent parle de la rédemption.
Because silver was used for purchase of things.
L'argent est utilisé pour
Jesus, our Lord, was sold for 30 pieces of silver.
Notre Seigneur a été vendu pour 30 pièces.
And the price of a man's redemption, the redemption of a man's life, that was of silver.
Était avec l'argent.
20 shekels of silver.
26.
This was what God was saying when he said, and they shall not appear before me empty during the feasts. We will come there.
C'est ce que le Seigneur disait, ne devait pas venir à lui les mains vides.
I know churches are using this to collect offering. Say, they shall not appear before God empty. So bring offering.
Je sais qu'il y a des églises qui utilisent ça pour exploiter les gens qui ne veulent pas venir dans la maison du Seigneur les mains vides.
No, he wasn't talking about giving offering in church. When you count, God does not approve of counting his people except you bring the price for each person. God said, every firstborn shall be redeemed with a prize money. Amen? If you will not redeem him with prize money, kill it. Whether it's your son or the firstling of your animals, if you will not bring money in its place, break its neck.
Pray the name of the Lord. En ce moment, le Seigneur acceptait le comptage du peuple. Il devait nécessairement y avoir l'argent qui était emmené pour racheter cette personne.
So you will notice
that personne était,
So you will notice that. You will notice that every time God commanded the census, he would tell them to bring the redemption money.
Vous allez remarquer que chaque fois que le Seigneur a demandé le recensement, il demandait aussi qu'on apporte en fait l'argent pour le rachat.
That was the same deal he committed.
Ça c'est le péché que David a commis.
He counted Israel.
Il a compté Israël
without bringing the redemption money.
Sans apporter l'argent de rachat.
And God told him, oh God, you don't do this, so it's not done. God will not be happy with us.
Et ce n'était pas content.
David said, I'll be king. You don't have to keep quiet. Shut up. And he went on ahead and numbered the people. And God dealt with Israel. Very, you know, seriously.
Et donc David, non, c'est moi le roi, comptez les personnes, le Seigneur ne peut pas du tout compter.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
So, the price of a man's life,
le prix de la vie d'un homme,
is silver.
C'est l'argent.
And what was the price that was paid for us?
Et quel était le prix qui a été payé pour nous?
First Peter tells us that we are not redeemed with corruptible things.
On n'a pas été racheté par quelque chose de corruptible.
Or with perishable things.
Ou quelque chose de périssable.
Our redemption was very precious.
Notre rédemption précieuse.
With the blood of Jesus Christ.
Avec le sang de notre Seigneur Jésus.
In other words, when we talk about redemption, therefore, save, and therefore, we are talking about everything Jesus did to save you on the cross.
En d'autres mots, lorsqu'on parle de la rédemption par l'argent, on fait référence à tout ce que le Seigneur Jésus a fait pour nous sauver.
He paid for the forgiveness of your sins.
Il a payé pour le pardon de nos péchés.
He paid for the healing of your sickness.
Il a payé pour notre guérison.
He paid for your deliverance from Satan and all his cohorts.
Il a payé pour notre délivrance de l'oppression de Satan.
He paid for your release from falling satanic circumstances around you.
Il a payé pour qu'on soit libéré de toute emprise satanique.
He paid the price for your bad luck.
Il a payé le prix pour la mauvaise, la malchance.
Oh yes, he paid for it. It is done.
C'est fait.
In the name of Jesus.
And we do not have to carry those things anymore.
Et on n'a plus à supporter ces choses.
Anything Jesus paid for on the cross.
Tout ce que Jésus a payé à la croix.
As far as God is concerned.
En ce qui concerne le Seigneur Jésus. Le
it has no power over you.
Il n'y a
anymore.
Plus aucune puissance.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Le nom du Seigneur soit béni.
And so we can just look at the word of God and rejoice.
Donc on peut juste regarder la parole de Dieu et nous réjouir.
And come with thanksgiving.
Et venir avec reconnaissance.
Praising God.
Louons le Seigneur.
Because we are free.
Parce qu'on est libre.
Men.
Lord.
And when I say men, I am talking about men and women.
Je parle de l'homme, je parle de l'homme.
Praise the name of the Lamb of God. You understand that? Because when the Bible made man and the woman, he called them Adam. Genesis chapter
5. Adam.
Amen. Verse 1. He called both of them Adam. It was Adam that gave woman name Eve.
C'est Adam qui a donné.
It was not God. It was not God that called her Eve. It was Adam that called her Eve. And it was not a name of oppression.
Et c'était pas un nom d'oppression.
It's just like you call your wife baby.
Comme tu appelles ta femme baby.
Or darling.
Or chérie.
Or my own. All the names, the pet names we give. Amen. Only Adam did not use ones that don't make sense. Like some of us call our wives names that don't make any sense. Adam said, you are a life giver. Praise the name of the Lord. So if you want to give your wife the best name, please call her something good. Not
just the name the
wife is not a baby. Praise the name of the Lord. Alright, that's on it like that side. But that's serious.
Best name.
Amen.
Amen.
So everything that all men who now begin to understand and walk in this liberty.
Donc, tout homme commence à comprendre et marche dans cette liberté.
Are the people that are being called pillars.
Ce sont les personnes qui sont appelées
pillars. They are set in sockets or foundations of brass.
Ils sont ancrés dans une fondation de cuivre.
They are standing on the judgments of God.
Hallelujah.
Ils sont sur le jugement de Dieu.
Amen.
Amen.
Because Jesus Christ judged their sins.
Parce que le Seigneur Jésus a jugé leur péché.
They stand upon everything that Jesus did on the cross to provide their liberty.
Et ça appuie sur tout ce que Jésus a fait à la croix pour voir leur liberté.
And they stand by it.
Et ils se tiennent là-dessus.
If Jesus paid for my sins, I will not go back.
Si le Seigneur Jésus a payé pour mes péchés, je ne retourne pas au péché.
If he paid for my sicknesses, I refuse to be sick.
S'il a payé pour la maladie, je refuse d'être malade.
If he paid for me to be delivered from satanic oppression. I refuse to allow Satan in my life.
Pour être libre de l'oppression satanique, je refuse d'être sous l'oppression satanique.
People who begin to learn how to walk in that are the pillars in the house. They are the ones who uphold the beautiful gate for others to see and come into the
Hallelujah. Pour ceux qui marchent dans cette compréhension,
Amen.
Dans cette compréhension, ils sont appelés les piliers et ce sont eux qui montrent aux autres la beauté de cette porte.
Are you a pillar in the house?
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lamb of God.
Because this gate has to be held up all the time.
Cette porte doit être tenue tout le temps.
When you are holding up this gate,
quand tu tiens cette porte,
people will see you and say, "Sir, please, can you tell me about Jesus?"
Quand tu tiens,
your life is so tranquil and so beautiful. Please, okay. What can I do to be like you?
Quand tu tiens cette porte, les gens te voient et puis ils disent, "Ah, monsieur, madame, je vois que tu es si paisible. Comment je fais moi aussi pour devenir comme ça?"
You can boldly confess Christ to somebody else.
Et tu peux avec assurance confesser Christ à quelqu'un d'autre.
This is not the work of apostles.
Ce n'est pas le travail des apôtres.
Evangelists, pastors, prophets, and so on.
Des évangélistes, des pasteurs, des prophètes.
It is the work of those who have come to appreciate what Jesus did for them on the cross, and they are bold to share it with everybody that they see. These are the gates.
C'est le, mandat de tous ceux qui ont compris ce que Christ a fait pour eux. Et ils sont, ils sont équipés, ils ont l'assurance pour présenter Christ aux autres.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
On the other side too, the powers of darkness, there are men and women you meet on the streets every day. They are gates.
La même façon si dans le monde des ténèbres, il y a des personnes qui sont comme ça, des portes.
Amen. If you meet with them, you are going to hell.
Si tu les rencontres, eux te conduisent vers.
They are ready to tell you about the devil. They are ready to tempt you, make sure you fall, do evil to you. They will abuse you. They draw you away from the gates of heaven to the gates of hell. These are also called the gates of hell.
Donc,
gates of hell are people.
Donc il y a aussi comme ça des personnes qui sont des portes, qui sont aussi des piliers pour le monde des ténèbres. Quand vous les rencontrez, eux ils vont mettre toutes sortes de choses pour vous influencer.
Blessed be the name of the
Lord.
Hallelujah! Finally, on gates,
enfin,
these are men who, having been redeemed, can carry the gospel, the beautiful gospel of Jesus Christ to the ends of the earth.
Présente la beauté de l'évangile.
They are not doing it as apostles, prophets, or ministry gifts.
Ils ne le font pas comme des dons de ministère.
Those who open the gate for people to come into the salvation experience are doing so as children of God who are redeemed, not as ministry gifts.
Il s'agit d'enfants de Dieu qui ont été rachetés.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Do we understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
These men, these pillars,
ces piliers,
six of them.
Six
is the number of man.
Six le nombre de l'homme.
People set in sockets of silver.
Qui sont ancrés dans les fondations.
Sorry?
They have the main gate.
Oh, sorry. It's the main gate. Thank you very much. There are six of them. These are the doors. Mm-hmm. Now you have this here. There are six of them. These men are not people who carry titles, reverends and apostles, prophets, pastors, teachers. No. They are just men who are redeemed.
Des hommes qui ont été rachetés.
Redeemed man has been given the responsibility to preach the gospel to the nation.
Les hommes rachetés ont reçu le mandat, la responsabilité d'annoncer l'évangile.
Angels do not preach the gospel to the nations. No.
Pas l'évangile aux nations.
It is redeemed men.
C'est les hommes rachetés.
Amen.
Amen.
There is a song.
There is a song.
Holy angels cannot sing. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. There is a song only angels cannot sing. I once was lost, now but I am found. Angels cannot sing that. So, you don't find angels at the beautiful gate. It's men that are there. That was why it was Peter and John.
À la belle porte.
Who came there and said to the man, look, there's no silver or gold in this place. It's silver you need to deal with your problems. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Jesus of Nazareth, whenever it said Jesus of Nazareth, it always alludes to his death on the cross.
Quand il parle de Jésus de Nazareth, il fait référence à sa mort à la croix et tout ce que cela implique.
So, that is the first entrance.
Là, l'entrée principale.
Let's now consider the second entrance. That is called the door. Amen. Hallelujah. Entrance number two is the door. Amen. Glory be to God.
Amen.
Now, immediately after a man has been born again, the cross has done its work in your life, dealing with your sins and uncleanness.
Quand un homme est né de nouveau, l'œuvre de la croix fait son travail, traiter tout ce qui touche le péché.
Like I said, is these men who are redeemed,
ces hommes rachetés,
clothed with silver, upon foundations of brass. They are the ones who open this place for people to come into this place to get money.
Yes. C'est les hommes rachetés qui ouvrent l'accès à la deuxième porte.
But to now move from this outer court into the holy place, you require a new set of men.
Maintenant, pour passer du parvis au lieu saint, on a besoin d'une autre catégorie d'hommes.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And that is called the door.
Mm. Et ça, c'est appelé la porte.
Now, let's look at the scriptures. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Still in chapter 27.
Toujours dans Exode 27.
Hallelujah. I want the holy place. I will get that for us right away. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Let's turn to John chapter 10. First of all, I want to read the one in Leviticus as well. John chapter 10.
Jean 10.
I'm going to read it from verse 1.
Je lis à partir du verset 1.
Praise God in the highest. Okay, John chapter 10,
Jean 10,
from verse, then we will look at Exodus 26 after this. Alright, just follow as I read. I'm going to read it from verse 1. Verily, verily, I say unto you, that's in verse 1, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. But he that entereth in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the porter openeth, and the sheep hear his voice. And he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. Amen?
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Verse 9. Go to verse 9. Verse 7, first of all. Then said Jesus unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door
of the sheep. All that ever came before me are thieves and robbers. But the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved. And he shall go in and out and find pasture. Amen.
Amen.
But the thief cometh not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I am come that they might have life and have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. Amen.
Amen.
Now, turn to Leviticus chapter 26, verse 36. Sorry, is that Exodus? Okay, Exodus 26, sorry. Exodus, sorry. 26, verse 36. Okay. Yes, Exodus. Thank you very much, sir. Now, I want you to read that in French, 36 and 37. I want you to read it in French because you are going to need all the interpretations.
Okay. Donc, je lis Exode, chapitre 26, versets 36 et 37. Tu feras pour l'entrée de la tente un rideau de pourpre, violette et rouge, d'écarlate et de fin lin retors. Ce sera un ouvrage de brodeur. Tu feras pour le rideau 5 colonnes d'acacia. Tu les couvriras d'or. Tu leur mettras des crochets d'or. Tu fondras pour elles 5 socles de bronze.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, and thou shalt make an hanging for the door of the tent of blue, of purple, of scarlet, of fine twined linen, wrought with needlework. Meticulous, you know, handwork to design it. It takes the inworkings of God himself. Amen.
Amen.
And thou shalt make for the hanging how many pillars? 5 pillars of sheeting wood and overlaid with what? With gold. And their hooks shall be of gold, and thou shalt cast 5 sockets of brass for them. And we say, Amen.
Amen.
Now, look toward the board again. The second entrance,
la deuxième entrée,
is called the door,
appelée la porte,
as opposed to the gates.
Comparé
so take
à
a note. Take note of the difference.
Oui.
This door is upheld by 5 pillars.
Cette porte est opérée par 5 piliers.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, of course, when we say 5, 2 things come to mind.
Quand on dit 5, 2 choses me viennent à l'esprit.
Number 1, divine grace.
Premièrement, la grâce divine.
And then number 2, fivefold ministry.
Et 5,
or you call them gifts of men.
Ministères ou les dons aux hommes.
Amen.
Amen.
Gifts of men consisting of apostles.
Considered apôtres.
Prophets.
Les prophètes.
Evangelists.
Evangelists.
Shepherds.
Master.
Shepherd.
Berger.
And teachers.
Et enseignants.
Doctors.
Docteurs, enseignants.
All right. So, I want you to take a note of these. To enter into the holy place,
pour entrer dans le lieu saint,
you need to move through the door.
Tu dois passer à travers la porte.
And Jesus says he is the door.
Et Jésus dit qu'il est la porte.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, turn to Ephesians chapter 4.
Tournons dans Ephésiens 4.
Ephesians chapter 4, from verse 11. Or verse 13. Please, we are deliberate because we want you to get this. Amen.
Amen.
This is our message. This is what we believe. This is where we are going. Amen. This is why somebody said, why do we behave the way we do? This is why we behave the way we do. Blessed be the name of the Lord. All right. Now, verse, am I in Ephesians? Ephesians chapter 4. Okay. verse 11. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some shepherds and some teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying, the building up of the body of Christ. Till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. Amen. Amen. Now, five different gifts are mentioned here.
Cinq dons différents ont été, sont mentionnés ici.
Our friend brethren, are you following?
Yeah. Okay.
All right, we didn't read it in French because he's going to interpret it. Now, it is said that when Jesus died, if you read it from verse 5 upwards, when Jesus died,
dit que quand Christ est mort,
he went into the lowest part of the earth.
Il est allé dans les profondeurs de la terre.
When he resurrected,
quand il a ressuscité,
he gave gifts of men.
Il a donné, il a fait des dons aux hommes.
These gifts of men were now going to take his place.
Ces dons aux hommes vont maintenant prendre sa place.
Not take his place as in the lordship of Jesus, but to represent him.
Pas dans le sens de remplacer, prendre la place de la seigneurie du Seigneur.
They were now to represent him.
Mais pour le représenter.
And this is the door. He says, I am the door.
Il dit, je suis la porte.
Now he has given five different, you know, categories of men.
Et il a donné cinq différentes catégories d'hommes.
To stand in that gap.
Pour se tenir à cette porte.
They constitute the due order in the church.
Mm-hmm. Et ils constituent l'ordre établi dans l'église.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, the due order in the church has this. The Lord himself is the main person who gives instructions in his church.
Le Seigneur est la personne à la tête de son église qui donne instruction à son église.
That is the Lord Jesus Christ through the Holy Spirit.
C'est le Seigneur Jésus-Christ à travers le Saint-Esprit.
In the governance of the church.
Dans la gouvernance de l'église.
It is the Holy Spirit that has the number one say.
C'est comment appelle ça, le Saint-Esprit qui a le premier mot.
If the Holy Spirit has not instructed you to do anything, don't.
Si le Saint-Esprit ne t'a pas instruit de faire quelque chose, ne le fais pas.
Don't embark upon it.
Je veux dire, ne fais pas.
You will be going out of order.
Tu vas aller en dehors de l'ordre divin.
And then the next level is the gifts of men.
Ensuite, le second niveau, c'est les dons aux hommes.
Amen. And the gifts of men are five in number.
Et les dons aux hommes, il y en a cinq.
And they depend absolutely on the Holy Spirit for their operation.
Et dépendent absolument du Saint-Esprit pour opérer.
In the due order in the church,
dans l'ordre,
you have God,
on a Dieu,
Christ,
Christ,
Holy Spirit,
le Saint-Esprit.
Okay. Now, the second level of leadership in the house of God are the gifts of men, the fivefold ministry.
Ce sont les cinq dons aux hommes. Les cinq ministères.
Amen. The third order.
Le troisième.
Are the bishops.
Ce sont les bishops.
Elders.
Okay. Donc, les anciens.
And deacons.
Et les diacres.
Amen. Or deaconesses, if you like. Even the Bible. The Bible does not say deaconess because they are deacons. Whether male or female, the Bible calls them deacons. It's men that wants to feminize it and call them deaconess. They are deacons. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible does not have a separate word for it. Now, this is the way it works. God ordains these ones.
Dieu instruit les ministères.
These ones call these ones.
Le ministère appelle ceux-là.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So this is how it works.
C'est comme ça, ça fonctionne.
We don't know the qualifications of these people.
On ne connaît pas les qualifications de ces personnes.
The Bible does not give us, does not tell us.
La Bible ne nous dit pas.
Only God who called them knows their qualifications.
Seul Dieu qui les a appelés connaît leurs qualifications.
Like I always say,
comme je le dis toujours.
Sometimes when I see people functioning in these offices, only God knows why He chose them.
Seul Dieu sait pourquoi il a choisi.
A man like Paul.
Quelqu'un comme Paul.
After orchestrating the killing of many Christians,
après avoir orchestré la mort de plusieurs chrétiens,
God chooses him to be one of the greatest apostles that ever lived.
Dieu l'a choisi pour être l'un des plus grands apôtres que la terre ait connu.
And besides, he was not even married.
Et il n'était même pas marié.
Why did God choose him?
Pourquoi Dieu l'a choisi?
Only God knows.
Je
praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So we don't know their qualification. The Bible does not state their qualification.
La Bible ne nous donne pas le particular, donne pas d'instructions sur leur qualification. Seul Dieu.
But to make their work easy.
Mais pour faire leur de travail facile.
To make the work of their oversight easy, God instructed them to pick bishops, elders, and deacons.
Donc pour rendre leur travail facile, Dieu les a instruits de choisir des anciens, des diacres.
Amen. Amen. And God stated by Himself the qualifications for these people.
Okay. Et pour ces personnes, le Seigneur a donné des qualifications.
God said they must be the husband of one wife.
Dit, ils doivent être mariés d'une seule femme.
They must not be drunkards.
Ils doivent être alcooliques.
They must be family people whose children are behaving well.
Okay. Ils doivent être des personnes de famille dont les enfants ont un bon témoignage.
Amen.
Amen.
And they must be people who are not fighting on the streets.
C'est pas les personnes qui doivent être en train de se battre.
They must have a good report both in the church and outside the church.
Ils doivent avoir un bon témoignage autant dans l'église que à l'extérieur.
Does it mean these people are perfect? No.
Est-ce que ça veut dire ces personnes sont parfaites? Non.
But you see, God knows what He's looking for.
Dieu sait ce qu'il recherche.
There are definitions for that. I mean, that you know a man is bad, he's bad.
Tu sais qu'un homme est mauvais, il est mauvais.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Now, unfortunately today, bishops are the ones laying hands on people to appoint prophets, apostles, and teachers in the churches.
Malheureusement,
c'est une confusion in the church system.
Malheureusement, aujourd'hui, c'est les évêques, les bishops qui désignent les apôtres, les prophètes, etc. Donc, l'ordre est complètement renversé.
It's confusion.
C'est la confusion.
You understand that?
Vous comprenez cela?
Because these people are higher than these people.
Parce qu'en fait, en réalité, ces personnes sont à un niveau plus élevé que le celle-là.
You have a question?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry?
Okay.
Do the bishops, elders, and deacons that you're talking about recognize the minister
that
is the second step you write for
yes.
The ministry? So my question is, do the bishops recognize
whether they are higher? You mean whether they are higher?
Yeah.
No, they are not. These were ordained by men. They were chosen by men, not by God.
I know, but you say the minister gave orders to the bishop, right?
God appointed these ones.
Yes,
exactly. God gave instruction to the ministries to appoint this.
Et les ministères, c'est eux qui désignent.
So you understand that? Yeah. So these people are higher.
Ces personnes ici
dans this one.
Sont à un niveau plus élevé que les personnes
so
ici.
My question is,
la question est la suivante.
Yeah. Do the bishops recognize?
Est-ce que les bishops reconnaissent les ministères?
Whether they recognize the authority of this?
Yeah.
Well, obviously they don't in the church system. They are supposed to. They are supposed to recognize the authority of the fivefold ministry over them. But they don't, because now, in the church world, the bishops are higher than the pastors.
Okay, I'll be translating.
Do you understand?
Okay, donc la question c'est, est-ce que les anciens reconnaissent, les évêques reconnaissent les ministères? Et la réponse est la suivante. Malheureusement, dans le système des églises aujourd'hui, ce qu'on voit, okay, c'est que ceux-ci ne reconnaissent pas l'autorité des ministères et carrément c'est inversé. C'est eux qui veulent désigner qui sont ceux qui détiennent les ministères. Mais c'est contre l'ordre divin.
Let me give you an example.
Laisse-moi vous donner un exemple.
Bishop David Oyedepo.
Le bishop David et Oyedepo.
Le livre
de Luke the Scriptures, Titus.
Remember, I want to use the church system. The one in the Bible is not denomination.
Also, Lord David Bishop. Should know David Oyedepo.
Okay, you should. Do you know David Oyedepo?
No.
He's a bishop. Oh, you don't know him. Do you know any bishop? Not. Thank God for you. You don't. you have not gone far. It's a good thing. Sorry.
Okay. Est-ce que tu connais Bishop Oyedepo? Un report, non, il dit ah, tant mieux pour toi. Tu es vraiment loin de ce système là, tant mieux pour toi.
Amen. So it's very good you didn't go.
C'est une très bonne chose que tu connaisses pas tout ça.
But you see, the bishops, I hear sometimes the bishops who say they are coming to ordain pastors and they will make all of them kneel down before oil on their heads.
Okay.
So from today you are a pastor. You are an evangelist. They appoint them.
Ok, donc ce qu'on voit dans le système de l'Église, c'est que on voit les bishops venir, c'est eux qui viennent ordonner des apôtres, des prophètes, des évangélistes.
The ones appointed by God, who is higher, and the one appointed by men, who is higher?
The one celui qui est, by celui God. Qui est, comment on fait ça, là, désigné par Dieu versus celui qui a été désigné par un homme. Qui est plus grand?
Praise the name of the Lord.
Goodness.
But if one of these people makes good use of their office,
on bonne œuvre de leur responsabilité,
they can become one of these.
Ils peuvent devenir l'un de ceux-là.
The Bible says if a deacon
makes
good use of his office, he can purchase a higher degree.
Faire bien son œuvre, il peut être élevé à un niveau supérieur.
Amen. And it is not that man will call him to appoint him. It's God that will recognize that this man has been faithful and lift him up.
Yes.
And he will begin to manifest.
Ce n'est
very serious thing.
Ce n'est pas un homme qui va le reconnaître et puis l'élever. C'est Dieu lui-même et qui va faire en sorte que cette personne va commencer à manifester ses ministères.
Amen. Yes, brother Joe wants to contribute. Yes.
I think that
je pense que
asking,
la question qu'elle pose,
this is my perception,
c'est ma perception.
Okay.
I think she thinks that the fivefold ministry people, or like the fact that they are grace capacities, ministry that God has ordained.
Mm-hmm.
So that, like you said, somebody who is a deacon, the grace of an apostle, the grace of a teacher, that God can lift that person to that level. And then he or she begins to function at that level.
That was what I just said.
You know what I'm saying? I think the way she understood is as if before getting the clarity you made now, she was thinking, okay, these five people are already ministering. So how does the teacher know that?
Ok. Je pense que la question, en fait, ce que moi je comprends, c'est que la réelle question qu'elle posait, c'est les personnes qui sont à ce niveau ici, les diacres, les anciens, autres, est-ce que eux, ils reconnaissent en fait les ministères, dons de Dieu aux hommes?
Alléluia.
Amen.
Amen. Now look at this.
Regardez ceci.
I will quickly round up this because time is good. But let me explain this.
Laisse-moi vous expliquer ceci.
These people manifest and you see them, you know them.
Okay. Ces personnes le manifestent, vous les voyez, vous le savez.
An example of somebody who was faithful as a deacon and lifted to become an evangelist was Philip.
Un exemple de quelqu'un qui était fidèle en tant que diacre et qui a été livré au niveau d'évangéliste, c'est Philippe.
Philippe was just sharing food in the house.
Philippe partageait la nourriture dans la maison du Seigneur.
And when the persecution started,
quand la persécution a commencé,
he moved over to another town.
Il est allé dans une autre ville.
And he began to manifest as an evangelist.
Et il a commencé à se manifester beaucoup comme un évangéliste.
He moved from here.
Il est passé de diacre
to here
à évangéliste.
And nobody.
Et personne.
Came to lay hands. In fact, the apostles were not there. Everybody was hiding for their dear lives. Okay. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
For à cette époque-là, tout le monde se cachait pour sauver sa vie.
Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. That's good. Now, the doors,
les portes,
the fivefold ministry,
les cinq ministères,
open the door into the holy place.
Ouvre la porte au lieu saint.
Now, in the holy place,
dans le lieu saint,
you find the church, the operation of the church.
Dans le lieu saint, vous voyez comment l'église
fonctionne. The way the church should function.
Comment l'église doit fonctionner.
This is where you have the candlestick.
C'est là que vous avez le chandelier.
Revelation chapter 1.
Apocalypse 1.
Amen. He said Jesus was seen in the midst of the candlesticks.
Il a dit que Jésus était vu au milieu du chandelier.
And the candlesticks are the churches.
In Asia. Et l'église.
And the angel of those churches.
Les églises, les sept églises d'Asie.
Yes. And the angel of those churches are the men who we are set over those churches. The angels to those churches.
Et les anges de cette église, au fond, c'est les hommes qui ont été appointés pour ces ministères.
Through this one, Jesus said, I am the door of the sheep.
Christ, je suis la porte.
If any man enters here,
tout homme qui entre par la porte,
he can find food.
De trouver la nourriture.
Amen.
Is that not what he said in John chapter 10?
Yes.
The table of showbread contains the food that feeds the people of God.
La table contient les pains de proposition, la nourriture.
Hallelujah. Yeah. So it is the fivefold ministry that opens this door for men to see the true Christ and to come in.
Les cinq ministères qui ouvrent la porte à l'homme pour voir Christ.
They have ability.
Ils ont les habiletés.
To perform or show Christ, reveal Christ to those who are seeking Him.
Ils ont l'habilité de montrer Christ à ceux qui cherchent.
They bring direct word from the Lord.
Ils apportent une parole venant du Seigneur.
They hear from God.
Ils entendent la voix du Seigneur.
They have definite messages.
Ils ont un message précis du Seigneur.
Apostles are messengers.
Les apôtres sont les messagers.
They don't just carry these things as gifts. I mean, as titles around.
Ils ne portent pas cela juste comme un titre.
Apostle is just a messenger.
L'apôtre est juste un messager.
God says, I have a message to deliver in Pilemutan. And I want you to go there and deliver it. You go there, you deliver it and you come back.
Le Seigneur dit, ok, j'ai un message à délivrer dans une ville X donnée.
Amen.
Là, tu donnes la parole.
There's nothing special to it.
Spécial.
But now, people, they have an apostle. We went somewhere and we met an apostle.
Maintenant, les hommes disent, je suis un apôtre. On allait quelque part, on a rencontré l'apôtre.
And honestly, it was troubling the way they were, you know, crawling. The kind of respect
et sérieusement,
was awesome. I said, this is terrible.
Et sérieusement, c'était dérangeant la façon dont la personne était honorée.
People fear these people more than they fear God.
Les gens ont peur de ces personnes ici plus qu'ils n'ont peur de Dieu.
If you say God will place a curse on you.
Tu dis Dieu m'a mis ma malédiction sur toi.
I'll tell you, come on. Yeah, but if they say an apostle will put a curse on you, or bishop will curse you,
la porte va
be afraid.
Là, ils sont effrayés.
Praise the name of the Lamb of God. You see, they are the ones that are given the authority. That is why it is where the church age is functioning.
Ça présente l'âge de l'église, comment ça fonctionne.
That's why it is here you have gifts of the Holy Ghost.
C'est là que tu as le don de Saint-Esprit.
You have apostles, prophets, teachers, it's all in this place.
Tous les ministères ici sont dans le lieu saint.
That's why there are five pillars here.
Et c'est pour cela qu'il y a les cinq piliers pour cette porte.
Those five pillars will come down with the close of the church age.
Donc, Okay. Ces cinq piliers vont s'arrêter avec la fin de l'âge de l'Église.
Praise the name of the Lamb of God. Amen. All right. Within the next, okay. He said I could continue in the afternoon. Praise the name of the Lord.
Okay.
So, I'm going to stop it here so that when we come back, we'll determine who these four pillars are.
Okay. Donc, on va s'arrêter ici, on va continuer l'après-midi. Puis, l'après-midi, on va voir que représentent les quatre piliers ici.
Men who are redeemed.
Les hommes rachetés.
Who have become victorious.
Sont devenus victorieux.
Over sin in good measure.
Sur le péché dans une grande mesure.
Are the officiating ministers here.
C'est eux qui officient dans le parvis.
The fivefold ministry.
Les cinq ministères.
Are the officiating ministers here.
C'est eux qui officient dans l'église.
These four pillars that we shall deal with when we come back.
Les quatre piliers dont on va parler quand on revient.
Are the officiating ministers in the Holy of Holies.
C'est eux qui officient dans le Saint des Saints.
Blessed be the name of the Lamb of God.
Le Seigneur soit béni.
We said we should look at the three entrances, three courts, and three priests. We've looked at three entrances, but we've not finished the entrances.
On a regardé les trois entrées, mais on n'a pas fini les trois entrées.
We've looked at the courts because we are dealing with the two together. We've looked at the outer court. It is the place of salvation.
On a regardé le parvis, l'endroit du salut.
Amen.
Amen.
The place where men operate to do the things of God according to His law.
Là où l'homme opère pour faire les choses conformément à ce que le Seigneur.
Then the holy place is the place of the church age, the place of the Holy Spirit and His operations in the church.
Et le lieu saint est le lieu où le Saint-Esprit opère dans l'Église, là and, dans l'âge de l'Église.
And this is where the church is.
Et ça c'est là que l'Église est. Thank you.